Yo, my name is DeAndré Noels, and I am a victim of living under the hood. You might ask yourself, what is the hood? What exactly happens in the hood? Well, it ain't pretty. It ain't no Game Boys and butterflies where I come from. My mama, she be working. My daddy, he be working. They ain't even got no money to get me nothing. We live in paycheck to paycheck. They ain't got no money to buy me nothing. I ain't got nothing to rock on my feet. Nothing. Until one day my mama, she bought me these really nice Spider-Man glowy tennis shoes. There was these Spider-Man light-up tennis shoes. And them shoes meant the world to me. And what happens in the hood when you got something nice? What happens when you got something nice in the hood? What happens to it? Some low-dog gangster come and snatch it from you. And they come up to me. I'm in third grade. And these fifth graders come up to me and they jump me. And they done steal my tennis shoes. They snatched it right off my feet. That was my first encounter with violence through bully-ism. After that, every other day, I was getting bullied. They steal my shoes. They steal my socks. They steal my t-shirt right off my back. And what I have to show for it? I ain't got nothing. The police don't care about me. I'm just another mouth feeding off the welfare. So I realized something. I gotta stand up for me. I gotta stand up for myself. That world is a dark and cruel world out there. Ain't nobody love you out there. Ain't nobody giving you no chocolates and no boxes and whatnot. You gotta go snatch it for yourself. So I was angry at the world one day. So I done do what any other pole, any other hoodlum would do. I started punching the wall. I was angry. I was mad. I need to get out. I need to let out my emotion. So I done punched the wall. So after about 20, 30 minutes of that, this man walks up to me. He go by the name of Janisse, he tells me.
Hey, just a second.
What?
You clearly need some help here, okay? You want a coach? I can coach you.
And he said, boy, what you doing? What you doing with your life? And I said, I'm here punching this wall. What's to you? And he said, boy, you know what you need? You need a coach. And I said, oh, is that right? And he said, you need a coach. And he is a coach. He said, I am a coach, and I will coach you.
Hi, my name is Coach Jennings. My greatest prodigy would happen to be DeAndré. I knew I saw talent on the street as soon as I met DeAndré in the middle of Detroit, in the hooded area. He had everything. He just didn't know where to start.
So he take me, he trained me. We box. Punch him a couple times here and there, and he make me an ultra fine fighter.
What drew me to DeAndré was I saw a little bit of me in him, and I suddenly was inspired to take the talent and unleash it to its full potential.
And then I realized something. He ain't just a coach for no boxing ring. He a coach for life. He my life coach. He be up in my house, waking me up at 5 o'clock in the morning, making me things to drink to better my health.
Usually our days start out with off with two eggs that we blend up. Do DeAndré is ready to rule for a day's journey through life.
You can do that. You got this.
It happens to be his favorite so far.
And yeah, at times I don't like it. Sometimes I think that he go a little bit overboard, but in the end, I know he's there for me. He's there for me when nobody else was there for me.
After DeAndré B begins his day with his breakfast of 2 raw eggs, his warm-up begins. This consists of around 1,000 push-ups, about 500 sit-ups, and the like. And we also do a variety of flexibility exercises. DeAndre's favorite. Every day, every minute is defined by the man of faith that he is. Say, I love DeAndré very much as a brother.
He taught me how to hook and jab, and it goes something like hook, jab. You know? Like hook and jab. Just like that. It ain't that hard, but I punch hard.
I teach DeAndré a lot of moves. They're the hook and the jab, but I think DeAndré's specialty is what we like to call the stare. He just stares down at you, and with that, you're out cold.
Everybody done leave me. My mama left me. My daddy left me, except for Coach Jenny. And I owe him my life. And I would never had built up the courage to talk about my prior life of bullyism if it had not been for Coach Jenny's, to really let me open up that closet again of those scary moments in my life.
So until the day that we unleash the beast, please hope and pray that DeAndré will be the man that he was destined to be.
And he done make me a better person. The person that is here today, sitting at this chair, talking in front of this cameras. He made this man. Of course, Coach Jennings is my homeboy. I've known him ever since I was punching the walls.
Hey, don't want
to give me water or something. I'm chilling with my broad and you already know. If you wanna reach me, hit me on the down low. If I don't call back, don't put on a show. When I pass by your house and blow, instead of knocking on the door.